Okay, what we have here is a LP collection of The Ventures on Japanese virgin vinyl, a particular favorite of audiophiles because the vinyl is good quality and relatively low surface noise compared to the domestic pressings. This, we see the back cover has a line drawing of The Ventures that's actually a little different. Here's what the original domestic version looked like, and the line drawings on this Japanese version. It's a little different. Of course, the original had a photo of The Ventures on the back. But anyway, so I don't know why they went to the trouble of doing a completely different line drawing, but in Japan for this issue, but they did. And the other interesting thing about this issue is that I think it's the only time that the complete Walk Don't Run album was released in Japan. A lot of folks know The Ventures were really popular in Japan, but their first couple of albums didn't get released in Japan until the 70s. This was released in around 73, 74. This, I'm focusing in now on the picture of the guys on the front who really aren't The Ventures. The word is they were newsroom workers that subbed for The Ventures when Ventures themselves weren't available for the photo session. This is another Japanese copy. I don't have the obi strip on all of these, and so this is an example of one I don't have the obi strip. But you see it's got this different catalog number, and the LLP it says there. And then a different cover. I'm not going to pull out all the original covers, but in this case, this has a different back cover than The Ventures' second album. And again, as I say, I think that was from the early 70s as well. And probably the only time that album was released in Japan that I know of as an LP. It's been released on CD. Here's another in that same early 70s series, this LLP, and this is a Japanese copy. So it's that nice virgin vinyl. Here's another copy of another smash that was released in Japan. Now this one was released in the 60s. This was an earlier album that was released in Japan in the 60s, and it has this nice red vinyl. I pulled it out to show that, but and a very different back cover, as you can see from if you're familiar with the original. I'm pulling these out in the order that the Ventures albums were released, and so the fourth Ventures album released was Colorful Ventures. And here's a very, very nice Japanese copy from the 60s, also released in red vinyl. This is pressed in red vinyl, and excellent sounding copy. They changed the front a little bit, saying in stereo on this one. And then they re-released it in the 70s, earlier 70s, again around 73, 74. And same front cover. This one, I'm fortunate to have the obi strip, and it has a different back cover. And then here is yet another reissue of the album from Japan. Again, I'm liking these because of the nice virgin vinyl. And anyway, this they've changed the cover up again here. And this is actually a variation of the original domestic. Actually, I think it's more than that. It's really just a copy of the front and moved up. Anyway, and so here's another early 70s reissue of a Ventures album from Japan. And this one is their fifth album when they started getting into the twist. But the twist was, long out of date, and so they just call it dance. And it had been reissued this way even in the 60s, retitled Dance. And so that's the cover the Japanese went with in around 73, 74. Again, I have fortunate to have the obi strip. I think the reason collectors like to have that obi strip is the first indication that that the record was well taken care of. And it's not the only thing you need, but it's nice to have that. And then here's the next album that they had, the sixth album that The Ventures released, again with a cover that says Dance, whereas originally The Ventures would have called this Twist Party, it would have been called. And it has a different cover. I have an earlier Japanese version, and it has the original copy of the domestic cover. This would be a red vinyl edition from Japan, and again with a different back cover with all this Japanese writing. Mashed Potatoes and Gravy was released in Japan in the 60s, and mid-60s, I'm guessing. And that red vinyl version, this is how I played this one the other day, is a really nice copy of it. And then this is that same album, but it's the Mashed Potatoes and Gravy album, but it's now called Beach Party. You can't see it because of the... here it is, Beach Party. And this is the one that had a tune called Sputnik, and Southern California group called the Lively Ones took that and retitled it Surf Rider and had a hit with it. And so it's a Ventures original tune, and so the Ventures did well, I'm sure, in royalties with that. Here's a favorite. This is a red vinyl, mid-60s, I'll say, Japanese copy of Ventures, Going to the Ventures Dance Party. And this is a different back cover than what they released domestically, but that's another nice one. This is the same album again, but this is a black vinyl copy from 73 or 74 with a very different back cover, and different from the domestic and different from what they'd already released in Japan in the 60s. Here is Telstar album in an abridged version with only 10 songs, and it's red vinyl, 10-inch size, not the full 12-inch LP. And this was released in the 60s in Japan, red vinyl, and that's kind of a neat variation of it. Then they also put it out in Japan in the 60s on red vinyl again, the Telstar album, but they retitled it Caravan. And they took off the tune Last Night and replaced it with Caravan. So they didn't, throughout the 60s, they hadn't released the complete Telstar album. Here's yet another copy of the Telstar album with a different cover issued in Japan. This is red vinyl as well, I'm pretty sure. But again, they've changed a couple of tunes. I think they took two tunes off of this and off of the original, the domestic Telstar album, and replaced them with something else. Here's an 80s issue, and it is the complete Telstar album, as was released in the United States, but this is a nice Japanese copy. Now they have all the songs intact. And this is the domestic cover, the way it would have looked in the U.S. as well. This is a Japanese issue of Bobby V Meets the Ventures, and I'm guessing this is from the 70s as well. Have a nice Japanese issue. This is a Japanese issue of Let's Go, and this is one of my favorite Ventures albums. I'll talk about a little bit of controversy there. It's got this Japanese catalog number and a different back cover than the U.S. version, the domestic version. This was released. This one was an early 70s issue in Japan. The tune More and what else? Wipeout are featured on here. And in fact, it's, these are two songs that the Ventures themselves, not a single Venture, actually played on. It's kind of overstated that Ventures had session players playing their song or playing on their albums. And that's it's exaggerated. It did happen in this case with these two songs, but didn't happen in too many other instances, as many as people like to say anyway. Some people say, oh, the whole albums were studio players, and that's not true. So here's a early 80s issue of Let's Go in Japan, or released in Japan. And that's the domestic version of the back cover, and they used for that issue. This is a pretty hard one to find. It's the only time that an album called The Ventures Play the Country Classics was released in Japan. And this was released in the 70s, mid-70s. And this is a particularly nice copy of it. I actually had to buy two of these. One had a bad cover but an excellent vinyl, and the other one had a great cover but not great on the vinyl. One of the songs had a little nick in it or something. So anyway, I put the best of the two together, and this is a very nice copy of The Ventures Play the Country Classics. The album cover has nothing at all to do with the way it was issued in the United States. And you can't even read the titles here. But I guess at the time, country was not very big in Japan. I know there was a period in Japan where country was popular, American country music. But so that Ventures album had only one issue. Here's the Ventures Surfing album. And as it was released in Japan in the 60s, and pretty much the same cover that we see in the U.S. version. And I have the vinyl pulled out again just to show that that's another example of the red vinyl they used on most of the 60s LP releases in Japan. Red vinyl. The last one for this volume anyway, is the Ventures Surfing album. And another copy, and this is very much like the way it was released in the U.S., much more so than even the last copy was. Oh yeah, so here's the last cover. But anyway, this is early 80s, late 70s this was released, and anyway, that's I think the last in this series, and then I'll this is what I was going to say. This is the last of the Fender albums, although some people say that Nogi played a Mosrite on here, and it kind of doesn't sound very much like a Fender when I hear it. But the Mosrite is not being introduced on this cover, and so in the next volume we'll start the Mosrite years. And anyway, that's it for this one.